Why is it that people are so mean? Ladies, please stop passing through Libya route. It is very deadly. It is very dangerous. A lot of things happen there. The video I watched this morning has really spoiled my day, honestly. I can't believe that somebody can turn himself into a beast and flog somebody like this. Hi guys, you're watching Mchiki series. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you for your support. I quite appreciate that. It's good to have you around again. And if you're new to this channel, thank you for clicking on this video. Make yourself comfortable. As we get right into the gist, also remember to hit that red button. That way you get our latest updates. If this is Nigeria, this man must be arrested. But unfortunately, it happened in Libya. Right now, they're looking for his family. But I tell you, karma will catch up with this guy. Because what this guy did to this lady is very bad. What he did to her, I can't even think about it. Nobody can do it to any animal in Western world that you get arrested, not to talk of human being. The annoying thing is that this man is an Igbo man. So you saw your sister in foreign land, you couldn't find a way to help your sister. You people, because you people are doing business of sending women to go and prostitute and bring money for you people. That was why you decided she slept with her boyfriend, she didn't bring money, and you people decided to give her the beating of her life. Not just that you people beat her, if you see the materials that they were using to beat this, if you see the fat cane or whether they were using rubber, all manner of things they were using hitting on this girl. The girl that is very fair, if you see her body turned purple or even black. Her body turned purple, they poured water, that one was not enough, the other one said poured water in Igbo. They poured water and they continued. These people are just animal in human skin. I've never seen something like this. I hope they will be able to find this guy and arrest him. More than five men, some of them were speaking Igbo there. They pinned this lady down and they were hitting her so hard. They removed all her clothes and they were just flogging her left, right and center. And the lady was crying, wailing. At some point, they had to cover her mouth. You know when somebody is crying and you cover the person's mouth, the person will not be able to cry. Not because the person doesn't want to cry, but they've already covered the person's mouth. These people are mean. You need to see this video. I can't really post it on YouTube because it's going to be blocked. The kind of beating they gave this girl. And this is just one of it we've seen. There are so many cases like this happening in Libya that nobody gets to talk about it. It's because this lady, they filmed her own and put on the internet. These people need to be arrested, honestly. And let me say this, this doesn't have to do with tribe. There are so many videos I've watched about different tribes in Nigeria doing a lot of things in Libya. Why are they beating this lady? Towards the end of the video, the guys were telling her, look at you, let us see what you have in between your legs. You went out to sleep with your boyfriend, you can't even collect money from the person. What they do is that those ladies in Libya, they send them to go and sleep with men and bring money. So if you don't bring money, they will hit you so hard like this. This illegal immigration network is a cartel. There are so many people involved in it. That's why I don't advise any man or woman to pass through Libya route. Libya route is very dangerous. Am I talking about Sahara Desert? I don't want to talk about what happened to them even while in Mali before they start crossing Sahara Desert. Why they get on that perilous journey? A lot of things happen. Women get abused. Some people are raped. They have children on the ways. Before they even get to the promised land, the Europe that they're going to. Ladies, please stop passing through Libya route. I keep saying this all the time, but people will come and tell me, oh, do I have anything to give them in Nigeria? Why am I telling people not to relocate or migrate? I'm not telling you not to migrate. If you want to migrate, please migrate legally. There are different ways to migrate from Nigeria legally. Stop going through Libya route. It is very, very deadly. There are so many things that happen there. Some people don't understand this because most often these people, they don't tell you what is waiting for you. People like him, they are used as an agent. They'll find a way to lure you to come because they are looking for customers. They make money through there. The ladies then, he will send them into prostitution. Then you go and sleep with man and bring money for him. I saw a video like this. Was it 2 years ago or was it last year? I can't even remember. This one was a woman and the man. They are couples. They brought this lady to Libya, or whether they found the lady there, I don't know. They were interviewing the lady. You went out, you didn't bring money. Why didn't you bring money? How much did you bring? And stuff like that. That was the question they were asking. And my heart just sank. A couple, husband and wife, that was what they were doing. But this guy now, I don't know his family background. I don't know his situation. I don't know whether he's married. But what this guy did to this lady is very, very bad. If there's a way to arrest this guy, I know that he's in Libya. let them find a way to arrest this guy. The annoying thing is that this man is in a foreign land. This man is an Igbo man, and the lady that they were beating is also an Igbo girl. So this man cannot find a way to save the sister. So that money he's making there is so important to him that all of them, about four of them, gathered over this girl and they were beating her mercilessly. This girl was begging them, they were beating her. I know that there are other tribes also doing that. Honestly, I don't like talking about the Libya issue because there are so many things that are involved in it. What they do people at that Libya, they can't do it to animals. And some people, they don't even get to Europe or get to developed country. Some of them, their journey stops at Libya. If you have little businesses you are doing in Nigeria, concentrate on it and find a way to make a living out of it. You think that there are so many jobs looking for you, that money is working on the street. There's no place where money is working on the street. If you have little thing you are doing in Nigeria, you find a way to put in your hard work and save your money so that you'll be able to migrate legally. Because the same thing I see about mates in Dubai, all these ladies, they promise them good job. At the end of the day, you know that their Nigerian qualification, if you go to another country, you need to do another degree or certificate course or something before you'll be able to work, or you do like a 2 weeks training or something for you to be able to work. But some people don't understand it. Somebody will come from nowhere and promise you job. The next thing you see, if it's somebody who is doing little business, maybe you're a hairdresser or you're a seamstress, you're sewing clothes for people. Some people, they even have businesses, small businesses that they're doing. You see them fighting to raise money. Maybe they tell you to pay like 350 or 500 or some 1 million. Then you raise your money, you take all your life savings and give to these people, thinking that you're coming to Western world, you're coming to Europe, that once you go there, everything is okay. Without knowing that you're moving from frying pan to fire, through Sahara Desert to Libya, some people make it at Libya by crossing through the Mediterranean Sea in inflatable boats that can easily burst in the middle of the sea and all of you will get drowned. Some people are sold as slaves in Libya. While some people are being abused like this lady in Libya, some people don't even end up crossing to Europe. Some people end up in Libya, they're being sold as slaves, some people doing hard labor, and some people are begging to come back and there is nobody to take them back. Some people, if you are lucky enough, the international organization will deport you back to Nigeria after so many years. So it's not really as easy as people think. And the typical migration route from Nigeria is that they move to Kano from wherever they are. From Kano, they find their way to Agadez in Mali. Then from Agadez, they make their way through Sahara Desert, which is another horrific journey. Passing through Sahara Desert is a matter of life and death because all of them are cramped on 4x4, this Hilux van, and they set off. So if you fall off, you're on your own. They hold onto sticks. Nobody cares about you. The Hilux keeps moving till they get to Libya. So when they land in Libya, that you are in Libya doesn't mean that you get to the promised land, that is Europe. Some people are forced to labor for nothing. You work, at the end of the day, somebody is taking your money. You don't get to have anything. They give you peanuts. And Nigerian government, this is to you people. The way Nigerians are migrating, leaving the country, is alarming. Some people, they don't even want to leave. But because the government is not helping matter, no jobs for youths, no security in the country. Boko Haram has taken over some parts of Niger State, put their flag. Buhari's administration, they're not doing anything. Nothing is done. Nobody is talking about insecurity in Nigeria. In fact, Buhari's administration is negotiating with bandits. There was a video I saw of Gumi negotiating with bandits. I've never seen a government that negotiates with bandits or negotiate with Boko Haram. The government doesn't care about the masses. The insecurity, Fulani herdsmen are scattered all over, butchering people, a lot of unrest in Nigeria. The government doesn't care about it. Each time they are negotiating with bandits, who does that? Are you encouraging them or are you telling the citizens that you care for them? As far as I'm concerned, this government doesn't even care for anybody. There is no enabling environment for the youth, no job for the youth. So at the end of the day, you see Nigerians moving up and down to different countries because everybody wants to survive. I don't blame people who are leaving the country because they want to survive. But people have to be careful the way they do it. You just find a way to do it legally so that you don't fall into problem, because there are also people out there that are very dangerous, ready to take advantage of you. Some people, they leave Nigeria but they never get to see the light of the day. Some of them, they've even lost their life. Also, be careful about these people that give you juicy offer when it comes to employment abroad. They will tell you that you do a very good job and stuff like that. I've already said it before, with your Nigerian certificate, it's difficult to get a job outside Nigeria. You need to do additional training to get on board, at least to start work. Before you leave Nigeria, people are promising you job. Don't fall for it. no matter your certificate in Nigeria, if you like have PhD, you go for training. So anybody that is telling you you're coming to work, you're going to do a decent job, you're going to do teaching,
any job that they're promising you so much, don't pay attention to it. Try to understand what is happening on the other side before you leave the country, so that you don't fall into the wrong arms. There are so many people out there, wolves in sheep's clothing, that are looking for who to devour. They're also desperate looking for money, because all these things boils down to money, and people don't have conscience. They're just there to do whatever they like, so long as nobody catches them and get away with it, like this guy now.
So guys, I just saw this video. It was very disturbing to me. I just decided to share my little opinion, my little 2 cents, my little 2 kobo with you guys. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. I'm gonna sign off here. Stay healthy and safe. Remember to share this video with family and friends if you love it, and subscribe to this channel if you're not done already. And I'm gonna catch you guys in my next video. Bye, and remain blessed.